Hi, I'm Jack Cushwood, Room Now. I want to tell you about an interesting rheumatoid arthritis study. I think this may have been the best study from EULAR 2020. It's a head-to-head trial of UPA versus ABA, upadacitinib versus abatacept, in patients who are biologic refractory, either had non-response or incomplete response to prior biologic therapies. 612 patients were enrolled in this randomized active control trial. Patients were randomized to either receive 15 milligrams of UPA or monthly infusions after a loading dose of abatacept. The primary endpoint in this study was a -28 CRP of less than 2.6, sort of remission, and at that would be at week 24. Again, the interesting thing about this study was it was designed as a non-inferiority trial, and in the end, it proved to be a superiority trial because upadacitinib was, in fact, more efficacious than was abatacept. Again, the numbers at week 24, 46% achieve remission with UPA, 31% achieve remission with ABA. Many of the parameters, LDA, ACR 20, ACR 50, ACR 70, were all significant at week 12. By week 24, ACR 20 was no longer significant. That's an interesting finding, but ACR 50 still was, and ACR 70 still was. I mean, ACR 70, 73% versus 26%. That's a really impressive number, especially in these refractory patients, because they will have already failed other DMARDs and multiple other therapies, including at least one DMARD, one biologic DMARD. So it was not a non-inferior, it was in fact a superior outcome compared to its comparator drug. The interesting hook in this study is that while better in clinical efficacy, UPA came with a price. There was more toxicity with UPA. So many of the usual parameters were not bad, but some of the ones that are worrisome were higher. That would include serious AEs were more frequent with this with the JAK inhibitor, 10 versus 5. Severe AEs, 19 versus 10. Opportunistic infections, 4 versus 1. Hepatic disorders, very strange, but 23 versus 5, that's 7.6% versus 1.6%. There was no difference in shingles events, zoster, or in venous thromboembolic events between the two drugs. But UPA had more lab abnormalities, mainly grade 3 and 4 lymphopenia. 4 is less than 500, and that was 14.9% versus 8.4%. And grade 3 and 4 CPK elevations, 3 cases versus no cases. So, which would you use? Your patient's been through the mill, tried a bunch of things. Do you go to the newer JAK inhibitor? You go with ABA? It depends on what you want. Realize this is not a very simple study because these people are sick. They will have failed multiple other therapies. And in this case, they need something that works. If you will need something that works, you might be swayed by the efficacy data. However, if your patient or you are really worried about toxicity, maybe you shy away from the UPA and you go to ABA. But this is novel in that it is head-to-head. Rheumatologists love head-to-head. Not a lot of evidence that you, in fact, change your therapy when you get head-to-head results, but this could be a game changer. You know, UPA has been shown in other studies head-to-head to be better than, and you can say the same for other JAK inhibitors too, that JAK inhibitors and UPA are better than methotrexate, and in many instances, they are better than adalimumab. And now we have another MOA where the JAK inhibitor seemed to work. So I think this is a great study because it's moving the needle and the paradigm towards JAK inhibition in the future when these may become more affordable and more accessible. I think right now, you know, we're still locked into methotrexate because of cost and convention, but you know, the JAKs are going to challenge that, and especially being able to beat the competition head-to-head, methotrexate, adalimumab, and now abatacept, things are going to change in the future. Not this week, but in the future. Interesting study. Hope you liked it. This is Saturday, SAT 0151 is the abstract number.